My name is Betsy Howell, and I'm a wildlife biologist on the Olympic National Forest. The best parts of my job are when I can survey for different species, when I'm looking for restoration opportunities, just anything that takes me into the forest where I have the opportunity to observe what's happening in the natural world.
We need eyes and ears on the ground because what we do as wildlife biologists is actually go out and assess habitat conditions there. And that's habitat conditions going from the crowns of the trees to what's subtly under the soil level. And you can't do that in a remote fashion. Some of the species in which we're charged to manage and look for are subterranean. Some of them lived in cavities of trees. Some of them live under logs and branches. And so we actually have to get out there on the ground and look for those species. So part of the mission of the Forest Service is to provide for clean drinking water for the American people. And wetlands are one of those areas which we hold water and store water to filter down into the aquifers. Wetlands are also key habitat for a variety of fish species, aquatic mollusks, and then also amphibian species. And so as a wildlife biologist, part of our job is to be monitoring the health of those wetlands by monitoring the existing populations of amphibians and aquatic mollusks.
So when I come out to a particular wetland, I primarily am looking at amphibian species and bird species as well. But I try to locate egg masses during the winter and early spring when the frogs and salamanders are laying eggs, because that can tell me which species are occupying a site. I document bird songs that I hear. Of course, if there's any evidence of mammals, deer and elk, or predators, any kind of tracks. So just any kind of wildlife sign. I'm trying to get some estimate of the health of the area. So the more species that are using the wetland, you know, particularly amphibians, because they're such sensitive indicators of environmental health, as well as aquatic insects. If those kinds of species are present in an area, then it's a pretty good indication that there's healthy water quality, healthy vegetation growing in the area. I mean, it doesn't tell you everything, but if the species aren't there, then absence could be an indicator of a problem. This is a high elevation wetland on the southern part of the Olympic National Forest. Monitoring is important for areas like this because, for one thing, this isn't a very common habitat type, so its value is increased by its scarcity. The second reason is that, you know, changes are always happening in the ecosystem. So if you monitor, if you return to a site year after year, you can see what those changes are. And we know that the climate is changing and will continue to do so. At higher elevations, plant species, animal species, hydrological characteristics of a site are going to change more rapidly than they will lower.
The wildlife that we study do not just occur in any one forest district or any one forest. They span across multiple forests. They span sometimes across multiple states. And so it's really our ability as wildlife biologists to take the inference of what's going on at the local level, but then also take that broader look at that whole life cycle of that species and be able to understand what's going on outside of the Forest Service lands, even what's going on in adjacent private lands, so we can make sure we're meeting the needs for the species that depend upon us for certain points of their life. Many of the wildlife that occur on national forest lands in Oregon and Washington also occur in Canada and Mexico and South America. And so what we do on our lands has not only local impacts at the local level, but it stretches globally.
Oh, I think it's absolutely critical that Forest Service specialists and, you know, really all the different employees are out on the landscape as much as possible. I mean, ecosystem processes are always happening. People getting out repeatedly, especially to see the changes that are occurring over time, it's absolutely critical. Well, this has got a little look of elderberry, but I think it's just a salmonberry and deer fern. You know, there's a lot of stuff growing, or, you know, starting to grow in here.